time folds back on itself. Again, his senses scream as the very impossibility of what is happening assaults them. But the champion of light endures. Each time he gets a little closer, each time another detail falls into place. Now the trap works against the Herald of Darkness.
Okay. Back here again. Means I can go back to my magnum, which I quite liked. Oh. Well then, you're new.
Holy shit.
I know. You are definitely suited to my boomstick. Got ya. He takes a lot of ammo, shit! Okay. I'm gonna need a magnum, I think, for this. Just so then I can have more ammo, I can take him down quicker. I'm sorry, Boomstick, I'm gonna have to let you go, but I decided that anyway. Before I even got here, so that's something.
Right on cue, bubbling to the surface from untold depths, the horrors come. The emerging monsters do not expect the warm reception that has already been prepared for them.
Seems to be going a lot quicker now. Can I still splore? Or just again? Yeah, it's the same. Playing a different part of the song for once. Like, you're still gonna get copyrighted? I just uploaded part two and I got copyrighted. Oh, come on, man. Aim properly. Hey. Oh, a magic rifle. Whoa, whoa, whoa. How many more do I have to get? 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 20. I only have to get 5 more. 5. That's easy enough.
Stop. Saving Emma.
Wait. I want to splore, Alan. Hippy can wait. Hippy dippy. My good friend, hippy dippy blonde girl. She's not the brightest, but hey, she's a mechanic, so at least she can fix cars and stuffs. You know, she's a hippie, but she can fix my car. I don't have a car, but if I did, she could fix it. Any question marky things? Nope. Anything in here? No. Alrighty. No. Okay. Well, I'm guessing since, I'm gonna look around for the final few pages, because I'm guessing this is gonna go away pretty quick. Yeah, there's a page right up here. That's good. Hey, you! Is there one of those guys? Yes, there is. Take that, bitch. Yeah, I did take that guy out. He's nice, huh? Yeah! Well, that was close. Got ya. Okay. I'm gonna need a refill in a moment. But first... there.
Getting the Andersons into the recording studio was a struggle and a half. But once they actually picked up the instruments, something happened. They were two old men, and they weren't. They were doddering bags of bone, and they were barely contained power. And there was music. Barry rubbed his hands together. He knew how to pick a winner. Now all they needed was some direction on how to make things a little more modern. Barry had never produced a thing in his life, but he knew what he liked. He knew Balance Slays the Demon was going to be a hit.
Well, I like it, so that's something. I'm gonna go back to the assault rifle. What was it? SMG, that's it. The machine gun. So I have two automatics. Or whatever they are. I don't know guns very well. I could know them better. You know what? We should go and see our old pal. That's his name.
So I've been thinking about Barry. I don't know what to do about him yet. I mean, I'm not gonna keep him around, that's for sure. Al? Al? Ugh, little parasite. Your best friend. Really? That's the best you can do. I actually kind of like the guy. He's a plucky little butterball. He plays the clown. That's a hard road to take.
Plucky little butterball.
I don't need him sticking.
I have Sauron.
Fat face in my business. Did you know he's been hanging out with the sheriff? From that shitty little town? They keep in touch.
Fair due to it.
Barry's about the only guy who insists that you're not dead. How about that? I might keep him alive for a while. Just to see him go to pieces when I fire his ass. Yeah.
You don't touch my wingman.
Yeah.
He gets me out of shit. Don't! You fucking dare. You bitch.
You bitch, I am going to destroy you next time I see you, I swear to fucking God.
That was a normal voice. Where's that fucking thing? Ah, there it is! I knew that. Totally.
Emma wasn't sure exactly when the man arrived at the motel, but from what she could tell, the party started almost immediately. It was infectious, spreading from one room to another. He was mercurial, almost as if he was flickering through the scene, telling a joke here, throwing an insult there, oozing sex and violence and excitement. She had never seen someone like this before. He looked at her and smiled, and she felt her heart flutter a little. She knew he was the kind of man mothers warn their daughters about, but she told herself it didn't matter.
That's what all girls do, isn't it? Oh, generalizing, oh no. There's a page in there, I know it. You're not fooling me. I knew they'd have a Silent Hill pool-looking thing for a reason. Yeah.
I have seen the darkness twist flesh into new shapes before. But encountering these giants is an extremely disturbing experience. It's as if the genre has been switched on me. There's something out of Pulp Fiction. Twice as tall as normal men and stronger than forklifts, their lumbering gait and slow-witted demeanor brings to mind some kind of mean-spirited caricature of a feeble-minded hillbilly.
Pretty much. Now, how many more do I gotta get? 2. I can find those. Then I'll do the radio. Then... thingy. You know, all that good shit. Stuff. You know. You know how it is. Can I go in there again? No, blocked off. Alright, fair enough. Well, the sky's all different. I didn't notice! That's cool! Can't stop me, I'm a writer. Ever since Alan said that, it's just made me happy, like, yay! He's fueling my jokes! My crappy jokes. Yes, fuck yeah. Thank you, Alan. Let's go get the Magnum. You little bitch. I feel like I'm getting fairly decent with that gun. I'm gonna get the Magnum anyway. I guess you could say this will be my magnum opus. Hello again. There's two manuscript pages I just don't know where are. That's a pain. I've been everywhere. Except for the main area. Maybe they're in this area. If not, the... well, sucks to be me, I guess. I really doubt I'll be coming back here. You know? I'm pretty sure this is the final time.
Not as long as I show up, I guess.
Got you.
It's clear now.
But I'm still looking. Alan. They've got to be around here somewhere. Come on. Radio.
Well, art lovers, are you feeling neglected?
Mm-hmm.
You know Eddie Rodman's got love for you, which is why I actually hauled myself out of bed before noon, just so I could record an interview for your pleasure. Enjoy. Now, as I'm sure you all know, the annual Night Springs Visual Arts Show is coming around again, and that's a big deal for all of us that are in the culture business. If you can call it a business, that's a little controversial, I know.
Oh, that's okay. Money makes the world go around, no doubt about it.
And that's one of my guests here at the studio.
Serena?
Serena Valdivia.
Well then.
She's a curator at the Night Springs Gallery of Visual Arts, and she's in charge of the NSVA Film Festival, held this year at the old Night Springs Drive-In Theater.
Hello, Eddie. It's great to be here. And let me just say that it's a wonderful venue.
Absolutely. And with her is one of the filmmakers, somebody who's actually primarily known as a renowned photographer, Alice Wake.
Hey. Alan, your coat.
Fan, actually.
Oh, thank you.
You've gained quite a bit of fame as a photographer, but that's not why you're here, right? You actually have a film. That's a little surprising.
For me, too. I really wouldn't be here at all if it weren't for Serena.
You two are friends, I take it?
Yeah, we move in the same circles. So, about a year ago, I heard about all this footage she'd shot, and I got to see some of it, and then I started pestering her about actually putting it out there, because it was really good. I didn't really want to show it. It felt too personal.
Well, yes, I can understand that. It features your husband, and he's, well...
He's dead.
I thought he was missing.
It's been 2 years. This sounds awful, but yes, I believe he's dead. Otherwise, he would have... well, you know.
Yeah, I understand. Well, hold that thought, and we'll be right back.
I'm here! I swear, there's gotta be... pages. I just gotta figure out where. I'm sorry, girly! I gotta find them, it's sort of a thing now, I just really need them. Compulsion, I guess. There's two I'm missing. Just two. Two? Duh? Come on. Ah ha 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 ha. You're not fooling me.
The Anderson brothers should probably have been in a facility somewhere, despite their tendency to escape from such places. It could be argued that they had no business being on tour, considering their condition. Their lives mostly revolved around the laundry list of ailments and their endless quest for liquor. But Barry Wheeler managed them now. And whatever else they might say about Barry, he knew how to make things happen. And honestly, it wasn't like the Andersons were the most difficult clients he ever had.
Okay. One more place to look. Back here. Nope. Okay. Missing one. Just one. Just one. Just one! One more sweep and then I'll actually do the main game. I'll cut it out. Don't worry. They say it's easier to run sometimes. Nah. See, I collect things so I can unlock stuff. You see? It is all good, man. Okay, I can't find it. Let's hope it's just story progression. Nope. Alright, let me just get some shit. You know how it is. Hey, girl.
Yeah, thanks for saving me again. I'd hate to die before I'm scheduled to be murdered.
I guess I have you to thank for setting everything up at the oil derrick.
Yeah, well, I figured that if we were going to go over this again, we might as well try to be smart about it, huh?
Hippie, you're getting in my good books.
You took a big chance doing that. Are you okay?
What do you think? I've died twice. I remember everything pretty clearly now. You said I was gonna be okay.
I don't know what happened.
Well, it's not your fault. I think one of those, what did you call them? The takers? I think they did something to the power and they got me that way.
I'm sorry.
But I got the keys from the dead guy in that room. And I'm not handing them over until you do something about this. I'm sick of getting killed.
Fair enough. You seem calmer now.
I tried freaking out. It didn't do much good for me. I guess you get used to the craziest stuff.
Good for you.
Plus, I figured I'd take the edge off, you know?
Mm-hmm. Those herbal supplements are pretty good, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Definitely a hippie.
I wanted to try to explain things to you now since you're calmer, but maybe this isn't the best time after all.
Oh, shit. Yeah. Better not get all metaphysical on me now. Seriously, I'm like two sentences away from thinking how we could all be like atoms on God's skin or something. Jesus.
Figments of somebody's imagination?
Wow. I'm just gonna try to chill out and not think about that or getting murdered or anything, if you're cool with that.
Gotcha.
Yeah, hippie, you rest. And I will, go sort your problem out, okay? Give me that? Nope, okay. Hey guys. Yeah, okay, I missed a bit too many times for my liking there. Bleh! All right. That was pretty bad, I'm sorry. Yee. Don't die now! I can pick one up now. Hey! Cool beans. Hey, girl.
Okay. I really don't think they can get to the power now.
Thank you. That's a relief. Here's the keys that you needed.
Thank you.
Hey, I have to tell you, at the diner, I went there with him. The guy who looks like you, okay? I know I said that I didn't.
Yeah, I figured. Want to talk about what happened at the diner?
There was this guy from the observatory, and he just attacked the poor dude, smashed his face into the tabletop a bunch of times. It was horrible. I didn't know that he was gonna do that. I swear. And I just ran. I just left him there. I didn't even try to help.
There was nothing you could have done. It's not your fault.
Well, he's dead in that motel room now, so excuse me if I feel pretty shitty about it anyway.
You shouldn't blame yourself.
I just didn't want to get involved. I have this tendency to just drop everything and run. I don't think I'm a bad person, but I didn't even call the cops. I'm such a coward.
If you'd called the cops, we'd have dead cops. He's not human. Do you understand? It's not your fault.
But I could have tried to stop him.
Believe me, if you had, you'd be dead.
Uh-huh.
You seem to be doing a little better now.
Yeah, I guess it just got easier once I got this thing off my chest. I just feel so guilty about it, especially because I didn't pick up on any of the warning signs. I just really liked hanging out with him, you know? He was smart and charming and funny and hot. The way you could be, I guess.
Yes.
What's the deal with this guy anyway? He looks like you, he uses your name. Why does he do this stuff?
He's an asshole?
I'm not sure myself. Maybe he's just evil or my dark half. He does a lot of the stuff I'm trying really hard to get away from. Things that just messed up my life.
I guess all those murders don't help either.
Yeah, I could do without the murders and the end of the world. Listen, I need to get going.
Yeah, go. I think I'm good now, I hope.
Good luck. If it all goes well, maybe this is the last time we meet like this.
God, wouldn't that be great?
Just keep those lights on, okay?
I'm really ticked off that I can't find that last page. Really ticked off. Maybe I'll get lucky and it's hiding somewhere in here. Eh. That's good, I suppose. It's okay, Alan. Jeez, calm down. Dude. That's giving me extra stuff, so that's nice, I guess. I might have to go get that page later unless I do come back one more time, but I really doubt that. We'll see. I don't remember being able to walk in there before. Maybe I just wasn't looking. Okay. Off we go again.
The fate of countless individuals hangs in the balance, threatened by the machinations of the Herald of Darkness. And yet, for a moment, the Champion of Light breathes a little easier. He has saved one life. For this moment, it is enough. And soon, perhaps, he can put an end to this.
Yay!
Old gods of Asgard. I still don't quite know what to make of them. I know they used to be rock stars who modeled their stage personas after Norse gods. I know they're old. I know that in their day they fought the darkness as I do. I know they're demented and insane, ravaged by age and self-abuse. But there's something in them, Something powerful that took hold when they were touched by the powers beyond. A thing that goes far beyond just stage names. Something godlike.